President Crow, thank you for joining me on Break It Down. Let me just start off by congratulating you for getting elected into the National Academy of Science. It's probably one of the most prestigious organizations in the world. How does it feel? How did your election feel when you learned of it?
Well, Eleanor, thanks. It's nice to have a chance to chat. It's the American Society for the Advancement of Arts and Sciences, which was founded way back in 1780 with a bunch of our revolutionary founders and people like that. And so for me, a working class kid to get elected to something that had people like that in it, I was like, wow. So I'm not even sure how these things happen. So to me, I'm just sort of, somebody wrote me a letter and said, you've been elected to this. I'm like, well, that's exciting. And so then I tell my stepmother and my sister and they're like, what? I come from a family where I knew my great grandmother, who was from Missouri. Wow. And she was born in the 1880s. And when I went to college, she said, Michael, is that because you don't think you're going to be able to get a job? When I got my PhD, she said, well, we know what that means. We know what BS is, don't we?
Oh, wow.
You got your master's and that was more of the same. And your PhD is just the same thing. And it stands for piled higher and deeper. So to get elected to these things is very exciting. And I'm very honored.
So I didn't realize that you were a first generation college student.
First generation Section 8 kid, grew up in public housing. My dad was in the Navy. It's weird when I see a box of Velveeta cheese, my mind takes me back to the government issue cheese, which was some form of Velveeta cheese, and my mouth starts watering. And my wife says, you can't keep eating that stuff. You got to give that stuff up.
Well, that's quite a journey. So again, congratulations again. I wanted to just ask you about COVID. Now, I have a confession to make. I collaborate with a lot of scholars at different universities around the country, public universities, private universities. And as you know, when we talk, we commiserate together.
Yeah.
I have to say that when we compare the COVID response from our universities, ASU has done pretty well with as far as COVID is concerned with the development of the saliva test, and the wellness app, keeping track of symptoms and all of that. So how are you feeling about how ASU has handled COVID so far and what's coming in the future?
Well, the COVID pandemic is a huge revelation about how complex the world really is and what we have to look forward to and how much work we have to get done. And so I was very happy with the response of our university community. We graduated 30,000 students since the beginning of COVID. We were open every day, every minute of every day. We had hybrid classes, online classes. We built a COVID test. We did more than 1 million tests for COVID. We've given more than 1.25 million vaccines for COVID. We've got, everything imaginable going on. But most importantly, we're a better institution than we were prior to COVID. We're more innovative, more adaptive, more understanding. I think we're more family-centric. I think we have a better understanding of how to better run the university, how to be of better service. We've got tens of thousands of high school students now attending the university also as a part of their high school experiences. So, we're just a better institution. So COVID's been a very significant thing in every possible way, but also a powerful force for us.
That's great to hear. Now, I know that ASU is returning to in-person instruction in the fall. I won't be here because I will have my sabbatical this fall. Very happy about that. But for the fall semester, are students being required to have a vaccine before they return, or is it an option for students if they want to come back in the fall?
Well, right now where we are is we're expecting people to get vaccinated. And if you're vaccinated, you're going to have all kinds of privileges. And right now, if you're not vaccinated, you won't have those privileges. And so I don't know how we're going to best communicate it. We're just waiting a little bit further for the vaccines to get a higher level of certification. And so where we are is we have about 75% of our staff and faculty are vaccinated. Lots of our students are vaccinated. We've got ubiquitous vaccines available for everyone. So we're just hoping everybody gets vaccinated and we'll sort of see how the virus goes. And our plan is to use every imaginable tool to be fully operational for the fall semester.
Okay. Again, I won't be here in the fall, but I'm sure things will go smoothly as they have for the past year. And I also wanted to ask you about the 25 item actions you committed to last summer in the wake of the George Floyd murder in response to the resurgence of Black Lives Matter. So how are you gauging sort of the success of those 25 principles? Are there specific milestones and benchmarks? And I've recently witnessed the Lyft videos. You participated in one of the Lyft videos.
Yeah. Yeah. So Eleanor, what we're doing is, you know, the progress is we got to get all these things launched. So we launched the postdoc hiring. We've launched the faculty expanded diversity hiring. I think the group is about to make its recommendations on the new centers that we're going to be putting in place, the new programs, the multicultural centers we're going to be putting in place. We've got progress being made on all 25 of those activities, and then lots and lots of other things that come out of the discussions and come out of the efforts and so forth. So for us, progress is measured by doing the work. And so by making these things happen and stopping just talking and measuring doing. So we're in the launching and doing phase now for most of these things and about to launch for several. And so I think we're making good progress, and that's how we're going to measure our success.
Okay. Well, I rarely do this, President Crow, but is there anything you'd like to say to the viewership before we close?
Well, I mean, mostly we should look at this moment in time as a moment in time where we are about to take huge forward steps. You know, we now have a better notion of what injustice really means in our society. We have a deeper understanding of what it means to be connected globally through the pandemic. We have a deeper understanding of how valuable our democracy is and how important it is that it be fairly operated and justly implemented. I mean, this is a truly powerful moment in our society across many dimensions. And I hope that people aren't discouraged. I hope that in fact, they are encouraged. If one looks at all the things that are happening culturally, relative to our democracy, happening scientifically relative to the vaccine, it's all unbelievably powerful. And I just hope that people take some encouragement from where we are and where we're headed.
I agree. I think this is an inflection point if we bend the arc, as Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. would say. Well, thank you, President Crow. Thank you for appearing on Break It Down. It's been really nice to have you visit.
Nice to see you, Eleanor. Thank you.